नागवेणी, नागवेणी,
यस सर।
या कैन यू टेल मी व्हाट इज द टॉपिक आई हैव थॉट इन द प्रीवियस क्लास? व्हाट इज द टॉपिक आई हैव थॉट इन द प्रीवियस क्लास? कैन यू टेल? Yes, quickly, don't waste time. Already it's 12 o'clock. What is the topic I
Yes.
taught in the previous class? Yes, respond, na? If you keep quiet, then what I should understand? If you know, you say, I know. If you don't know, you say, you don't know.
I know, sir.
What is that? Just I'm asking the title. Yes, Rakshita W. Why she is
Switching modulator.
switching modulator, right? Already I shared the screen. Okay, fine. Fine, then let me start my this one, okay? So now this is fine. Right, so what I said, the switching modulator, right, consists of what? It is an AM wave generation circuit, right? So I can write the diagram. Yes, it has a diode, right? Then input is what? Message signal and as well as carrier. Okay, this is my RL, I say, and this one is what? M of T, right? And this one is C of T. Okay. So this one is V1 of T is the input. I'm taking output across the load register, which is V2 of T. I denote this by V2 of T. Right, this is what the circuit of switching modulator, right? So here we are making two assumptions. What are those two assumptions? Yes, what are those two assumptions? Already said in the previous class. One is C of T, okay, will be greater than zero so that it can switch on the diode or turn on the diode. Okay. Second one is diode acts as an ideal switch. A diode acts as an ideal switch. So what do you mean by ideal switch? Yes, anyone can say what do you mean by ideal switch? Yes, in the meantime, you also can load down the circuit diagram. Okay, whatever I write, you also can load down. Yes, anyone can say what is ideal switch? Hello, students. Hello.
Sir, it will either be in on or off state.
Yeah, when it is in on state, it acts as a closed switch and it offers zero resistance. Right? And when it is off, we say it offers infinite resistance. Means it acts as an open switch. Okay. So let me write the expression for the input voltage V1 of T. I hope you noted the circuit diagram.
Sir, can you scroll on top, sir?
Top, okay. Yeah, circuit is visible, no? Top, what I have written? Switching modulator, title I have written.
Okay.
Yes, shall I scroll down a little bit? Is it, have you noted the circuit diagram?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so I can write the input voltage, right? I can write the input voltage. V1 of T as what? V1 of T is equal to, we say, carrier voltage C of T plus M of T. Okay. So, what I can write for C of T? C of T will be is equal to what? AC cosine of 2 pi of CT. Isn't it? So which is equal to C of T is this AC cosine of 2 pi of CT plus M of T. Okay. So this is my input voltage to the circuit. So let me call this as equation 1. Yes, sir, noted this one.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So what is the output voltage? The output voltage, I can write as V2 of T, right? The output voltage V2 of T is, that is across load resistor, right? So V2 of T will be equal to, I can write it is V1 of T, right, when C of T is greater than 0. Okay, so when C of T is greater than 0, that diode will be turned on, so I get output voltage as the input voltage. Okay, V2 of T will be equal to V1 of T, and it will be 0 Right, the output voltage V2 of t will be 0 when C of t is less than 0. Is less than 0. So let me call this as equation 2. Equation 2. Okay, so here the understanding is what? When the C of t is larger than the cut-in voltage of your diode, then the diode will be turned on, right? So it acts as an ideal switch. Then the voltage across the load resistor V2 of t will be equal to V1 of t. Okay, so when the input voltage when C of t is less than 0, right, then the diode will be turned off, right? So I get the output voltage V2 of t as 0 because diode is open, right? So here what we are observing is the output voltage switches between two values. One is V1 of t and another is 0. Okay, so it switches between two values. No, that depends on what? That depends on the magnitude of the carrier signal, right? So when I said the C of t is greater than 0, I get V2 of t, that is output voltage, as V1 of t. And when C of t less than 0, I get output as 0, right? So that is why it is known as switching modulator, because the output switches between once V1 of t, another time it is 0, okay? So this switching operation, okay? So I can rewrite this equation 2 as V2 of t, okay, will be equal to AC cosine of 2 pi FCT, right? Say plus M of t into G T naught of t. Let me call this as equation 3. What is this G T naught of t? It is a periodic pulse train. Okay, so periodic pulse train. Why I am multiplying the input voltage with this periodic pulse train based on this equation 2? Because I came to know that the output voltage will be switches between two values only, right? That depends on the magnitude of the carrier signal. So because of that, I can write V2 of t, the input voltage into, which is multiplied by a periodic pulse train. Okay, so I can express this periodic pulse train . So if you take this is a time, okay, this one. So let me say this is a T naught by 2 and this one is minus T naught by 2 and so this is T naught. Okay. Similarly, this side. Okay, minus T naught. So I actually this is my G T naught of T. Okay. So G T naught of T. So what I say is I can represent this is G T naught of T. This is a periodic pulse train with period T naught. 43 students. Right, 43. Okay, so this is a periodic pulse train. I can say periodic pulse train. So having what period? period T naught is equal to period T naught is equal to 1/fc. So where fc is the carrier frequency, right? So means the switching operation takes place at the rate of carrier frequency. Okay, and we say the duty cycle is 50%. Well, fine. So how do we express this? How do we express this mathematically? This periodic pulse train can be expressed mathematically by using a Fourier series. Okay, so I will write that formula. I hope you have noted this periodic pulse train. Shall I write here? So G is G T naught of T is equal to G T naught of T is equal to, I can write this as 1/2 plus 2 by pi summation of n is equal to 1 to infinity, okay, minus 1 to the power of n minus 1 divided by 2n minus 1 into cosine of 2 pi fc t of 2n minus 1. Okay, so I can express mathematically this waveform, okay, like this by using a Fourier series. So let me call this as equation 4. Okay, have you noted this? 1/2 plus 2/pi summation n is equal to 1 to infinity minus 1 to the power of n minus 1 divided by what? 2n minus 1 cosine of 2 pi fc t of 2n minus 1. So now let me substitute the value of n, okay, and just expand for just the two values of n. Okay, it can be extended up to n is equal to infinity. So just for my this one analysis, I take I expand this equation till n is equal to 2 and let me rewrite that. Okay, so I can write G T naught of T is equal to, what first term is 1/2 plus, okay, 2 by pi. So when n is equal to 1, what I get? Just substitute and tell me when n is equal to 1, that above equation. So minus 1 to the power of n minus 1, right? So 1 minus 1 is 0. So anything power 0 is 1, right? So in the denominator, it is 2n minus 1 means 2 minus 1 is 1, right? Cosine of 2 pi fc t, 2 minus 1 is 1. So I can write just it is cosine of 2 pi fc t. Cosine of 2 pi fc t. Is it fine? So this is the term when n is equal to 1. Okay. Then when n is equal to 2. So when n is equal to 2, what happens? When n is equal to 2. So when n is equal to 2, see here it is minus 1 to the power of 2 minus 1 is 1, right? So it is minus 1, right? And here 2 into 2, 4, 4 minus 1 is 3. So minus 3 by minus 1/3, right? Into cosine of 2 pi fc t, Here n is 2, right? So 2 into 4, 4 minus 1 is 3. So I can write minus 2 by 3 pi into cosine of 2 pi, how much? 3 fct. Yes or no? So I can write the next term is what? Minus 2 by 3 pi, right? Cosine of 2 pi 3 fct. Okay. Then plus, like that you can write by substituting the different values of n. So let me stop for this only for two values, n is equal to 1 and n is equal to 2. So which is more than enough for me to do the analysis. Okay, so this is the expression for gt naught of t by substituting the value of n is equal to 1 and 2. So now let me substitute let me call this as equation 4. Okay, let me substitute the value of this in the what equation? In the equation 3. Okay, and expand it.
So this is 5, no sir, equation 5.
This is, okay, let me call this as equation 5. Okay, so the output voltage, right? V2 of t is equal to AC cosine of 2 pi fct plus m of t, okay, that into this one, or that 1 by 2 plus 2 by pi cosine of 2 pi fct, right? Minus 2 by 3 pi into cosine of 2 pi 3 fct, right? Plus and so on, so forth. Okay. So now let me expand this. So we can write V2 of t is equal to, so when I multiply AC cosine of 2 pi FCT by 1 by 2, what I can write? AC by 2, right, into AC AC by 2, right? Yeah, AC by 2, right? Cosine of 2 pi FCT is the first term, right? Then second term is what? M of T by 2, right? That is the second term. Then what is the next term I get? The next term plus S equal should tell 2AC by pi, right? Cos 2 pi FCT into cos 2 pi FCT. So I can write that as what? 2AC by pi, right? I can write it as cos square 2 pi FCT, na? Cos square of 2 pi FCT. Isn't it? AC cosine of 2 pi FCT into 2 by pi cosine of 2 pi FCT can be written as what? 2AC by pi cos square of 2 pi FCT. Right? Then, what is the next term? I can write. See, M of T is multiplied by with this one, right? 2 by pi cosine of 2 pi FCT. So, I can write this as okay, let me write here. So 2 by pi, right, M of T into cosine of 2 pi FCT. Yes, sir. So what is the next term we get? What is the next term? Now I need to multiply this AC cosine of 2 pi FCT by 2 by 3 pi into cosine of 2 pi 3 FCT, right? So I can write minus 2 AC by 3 pi, right? We continue with that, minus 2AC by 3 pi, right, into cosine of what? 2 pi FCT into cosine of 2 pi 3 FCT, right? And what is the next term? Minus.
So, so that 3 into 2 can be multiplied now, sir.
Yeah, I will take the next step. That is why I'm going step by step.
Okay.
Because cos A, cos B, we need to apply that rule here. Just I'm writing the first step. So next is what? I can write 2 by, right? 3 pi, right? M of T. I need to multiply M of T with this term. 2 by pi M of T. Cosine of this one, right? So 2 by 3 pi M of T cosine of 2 pi 3 FCT, right? Plus and so on, it will be continuing, right? So let me do that. So now two things are there here. One is this term, no? Cos square theta. Cos square theta can be written as what? 1 plus cos 2 theta by 2. Right? So you have to replace this cos square theta by 1 plus cos 2 theta by 2. So you consider 2 pi FCT as theta. Okay. Similarly, here it is in the form of you take higher one as A, the frequency which is having more, no? You consider this term as A, okay, and this term as B. Yeah, so cos A, cos B, you have to apply. So cos A, cos B is equal to what? Cos of A plus B, right? Plus cos of A minus B by 2. So writing that, you have to expand this one. Okay, so let me write that one. So now, this V2 of T is equal to, see, first term as it is, I can write, isn't it? AC by 2 cosine of 2 pi FCT, right? Plus, even second term also I can write as it is, right? M of T by 2, right? For the third term, we need to apply the trigonometric identity, that is what? Cos square theta, no? That will be equal to what I said, 1 plus cos 2 theta by 2. If I do that, what I can write for that one? I can write 2ac, right, by pi, as it is here. See, 1 plus cos 2 theta, right? I can write cos of 2 pi, okay? 2 pi, I will write 2fct, okay? Cos of 2 pi fct, right? By 2, by 2. Is it fine? Is it fine for this term, cos square theta, okay? Then I will write the next term as it is. I will simplify next step. I will write as it is the next one, that is what 2 by pi, right? 2 by pi m of t, 2 by pi m of t into cosine of 2 pi fct, right? 2 pi fct. Then what is the next term? What is the next term? We need to apply that rule now for this one. Yeah, this term I wrote. This term I wrote as it is. Then now minus 2ac by 3 pi. So apply that cos A cos B rule, right? Let me write that here. That is, I hope you are all with me. You are writing parallelly. So I can write this as what? Minus 2 by AC as it is by what? 3 pi. Then cos of A plus B, right? A is how much it is? 3fc, right? B is 1fc. So 3 plus 4 is, 3 plus 1 is 4fc, right? So I can write cos of 2 pi 4fct, right? I can write cos of 2 pi 4fct, okay, plus cos of A minus B, right? Cos of A minus B means 3fc minus fc is 2fc. So I can write that as cos of 2 pi 2fct. Okay, this is divided by 2. Okay, is it clear this term? And then I will write the last term as it is, this term. Minus 2 by 3 pi m of t cosine of 2 pi 3 fct. Okay, so let me write the last term as it is. That is minus 2 by 3 pi. 2 by 3 pi m of t into cosine of 2 pi 3 fct. Okay, then plus and so on, other terms.
So, so I joined in late, so I just had a doubt. Sir, can you go to equation 4?
Equation 4. This is the equation for
equation, sir, for g of t not of t. So this is a standard equation.
Yeah, this is the standard equation for expressing the periodic pulse train.
Okay, sir. And what does g of t not of t stand for?
No, this is a periodic pulse train having period t not. This t not represents the time period.
Okay.
That is why I written here, t not. So that period will be equal to what? 1 by fc, that is the carrier frequency duration.
Yeah, that is fine.
Okay, means I said output voltage, no? Output voltage across a load resistor switches between two values. One is V1 of t, another one is 0, right? So yeah, that depends on C of t, I said, no? So at what rate it is switching over between these two values? At the rate of carrier frequency.
Okay, sir.
Say that. That is why I'm writing here this input voltage is multiplied by that periodic train pulse. Is it clear?
Yeah, thank you, sir.
Shall I go to the next one?
Yes.
So here let us do some simplification. No? So I think I hope in this only I will do that. So what I can do, this two, right, and this two will get cancelled. I hope you understand, right? Isn't it? Similarly, let me do the cancellation of this two and this two also, right? This two and this two. Then okay, then after doing this, then let me write the next step, that is multiplying with this inside bracket, right? So first two terms we'll write as it is. So I can write V2 of T is equal to, what is the first term? It is AC by 2 cosine of 2 pi FCT, right? The second term is what? M of T by 2, right? Yeah, is it possible to say from your side, what is the third term? What I can write? Quickly, anyone can say third term, what I can write?
AC by pi.
Yeah, I can write third term as AC by pi.
Plus.
Right? Yeah, plus. What is the next term I can write?
AC by pi.
Cos yeah, of AC by pi. AC by pi. Cosine of 2 pi FCT.
2 pi FCT.
Yeah, cosine of 2 pi FCT.
So 2 pi 2 FCT, sir.
Oh, sorry. Cosine of 2 pi 2 FCT. Fine? Yeah. Next term is what? Next term is that is 2 by pi, right? Isn't it 2 by pi?
M of T
cos into,
of 2 pi FCT.
Yeah, cos of 2 pi FCT. Clear? Yeah. Next term. Next term is what? AC by 3 pi. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, AC by 3 pi. Then cos of 2 pi.
4 FCT.
Yeah, 4 FCT. Okay. So then what is the next term?
Minus AC by.
Yeah, the next term is minus AC by 3 pi, right? AC by 3 pi.
Cosine
of 2 pi. 2 pi. 2 FCT, no?
Yes, sir.
Then the last term I'll write as it is, that is 2 by 3 pi, 2 by 3 pi m of t into cos of 2 pi 3 FCT, right? Then it continues like that, plus and so on. So let me call this as equation, what? Is it six? Six, no?
Yes, sir, six.
Yeah, let me call this as equation six. Okay. Yeah. So now what I do in this is I take, I try to extract from this equation I would like to express or bring it to the standard AM waveform, okay, standard AM signal, by considering these two terms. What are those two terms? First term, okay, and this term, okay. By taking these two terms, Okay, I will take cosine of 2 pi f c t ac by 2 as common. Okay, of course in the second term ac by 2 is not there. I can rearrange that, right? So I will write that one. Okay, will I write here? So I can write v 2 of t as, so I said that into, I am writing 2 by AC, so that it will be only M of T I will get, right? This thing into cosine of, I think I wrote big one. Shall I erase and write? So I can write this as AC by 2 of 1 plus, okay, 2 by pi into, I am writing 2 by AC M of T. Okay, I hope this is understood now. This term cosine of 2 pi FCT. So if I multiply with AC by 2, I will get the first term as what? AC by 2 cosine of 2 pi FCT. The second term as what? 2 will get cancelled, because if I multiply AC by 2, right, AC will get cancelled, 2 will get cancelled. I will be getting 2 by pi M of T into cosine of 2 pi FCT only. Right? Is it clear? So why I am writing in this fashion is, because we know how we express the AM wave in the standard form, right? AC of 1 plus K M of T into cosine of 2 pi f c t, na? So that is why I wrote in that this one. Okay, so let me write the rest of the terms. What are the rest of the terms? Remaining terms is what? M of T by 2, right? M of T by 2, then plus, okay, AC by pi, right, plus what is next one? AC by pi
cos of 2 pi 2 FCT.
Yeah, AC by pi cos of 2 pi 2 FCT, right? Cos of 2 pi 2 FCT, right? Then minus AC by 3 pi, right? AC by 3 pi cosine of 2 pi 4 FCT. Right, 2 pi 4 FCT, then minus AC by 3 pi, AC by 3 pi cosine of 2 pi 2 FCT. Right, 2 pi FCT, then minus 2 by 3 pi, 2 by 3 pi M of T into cosine of 2 pi 3 FCT, right, plus and so on and so forth. Okay. Okay, so now See, these are all the different terms I get when I substitute that GT naught of T with the expression of V1 of T, right? Multiply and segregate, I get. But the required one is what? Required one I segregated, right? So what is that one? So this is the required term, I can say. Okay, that is a required term. So rest all unwanted terms. I need to eliminate that. So before I discuss how do I eliminate and all, let me just write that as the final expression for the output of the switching modulator. Okay. So I can say V2 of T is equal to what I can write AC by 2 of 1 plus how much it is 4 by 2 into 2 is 4, right? 4 by pi AC, right? M of T into cosine of 2 pi FCT. So this is the required AM wave. Let me put this in box and let me call this as equation. How much it is?
7.
7. Okay. And let me say, if at all we want to express in terms of that Ka, I can say Ka is 4 by pi AC. Okay. So we all know what is Ka. Right? Ka is equal to 4 by pi AC. And this one is the what? Sensitivity, right? Sensitivity. And how it is responsible for AM wave generation also, we have discussed, right, by taking different values of Ka, right? Yes, sir. Is it clear about this derivation?
Sir, can you explain the final output once again?
Yeah, I will again rewrite in that standard form only. Okay. So V2 of T. The V2 of T will be is equal to AC by 2 of 1 plus KA M of T right into cosine of 2 pi FCT. Right. So already we have discussed the equation for standard AM. What I written there just now at the beginning of this class, I asked, now that is AC of 1 plus KA M of T into cos of 2 pi FCT, right? So that is what we have got here, right? So when I multiply these things and by taking it common, right, I could express or I could extract the required AM wave, and these things M of T by 2 plus AC by pi plus AC by pi cosine of 2 by 2 FCT and all, these are all unwanted terms, what I can say. Okay, but the output of the switching modulator will have all these things.
Why are they unwanted, sir?
Yeah, see, wanted is what already I have told, the spectrum of AM signal, the frequency spectrum. If you have remembered, if I take M of F as the spectrum of the message signal with the triangular shape, right, then how do I get that M of F will be shifted by what, plus or minus FC, na? At FC and at minus FC, I get one unmodulated, that is the impulse function, right? And that spectrum of the message is shifted to that frequency. If you have, I will come to that, okay? So I say these are all unwanted terms. I need to eliminate these by using a filter. So I need to use a filter, so which will pass only the first term, okay, the desired one, and rest of the terms will be eliminated. So I need to use a band pass filter, okay, having a midband frequency. I will come to that now. Just if I say it is so much, you will not understand, okay, having certain midband frequency, right? So to understand that, how do we eliminate and all, I need to discuss this with the frequency domain analysis. Means I need to take the Fourier transform of, instead of taking Fourier transform to this equation what I have written here. So let me take the Fourier transform of equation 6, term by term. So then we'll have a discussion. I think that analysis we'll do in the next class, I feel, because already it is 12:50, right?
Sir, for AM wave, is it only AC or AC by 2?
Yeah, here AC by 2, its magnitude is divided by 2, nothing wrong. See, that is only the amplitude of the carrier. No? That is the standard equation what I wrote, AC of 1 plus KA m of t cos of 2 pi FCT, isn't it? So here I am getting the expression of what with the amplitude of the carrier is half, that is AC by 2 of something. So I am relating that to the standard form only, isn't it?
Yes, sir, you got it.
Yeah. Yeah, AC by 2 of 1 plus KA m of t cosine of 2 pi FCT is the required one. So I will do the frequency domain analysis Monday. Okay. So already you are aware now what is the Fourier transform of cos 2 pi FCT, right? Fourier transform of cos 2 pi FCT is what? Anyone can say? Fourier transform of just cos 2 pi FCT.
Delta of F minus FC plus delta of F plus FC.
Yeah, so delta of F minus FC plus delta of F plus FC, right? So, and another thing here, see, second term, right, M of T is multiplied with what? Cos of 2 pi FCT, right? So, here the multiplication of two signals in the time domain will be equal to what? Convolution of their Fourier transform in the frequency domain, right? And this also we have done while writing the expression for AM in the frequency domain. I wrote that, right? So if you are very clear about these two terms, so it is very easy to write the Fourier transform of this equation. Because see, once I know here cos 2 pi FCT is there, right? So M of T, its Fourier transform will be M of F. So it is M of T by 2, I can say M of F by 2. Similarly, AC by pi it is, right? So AC by pi into 1 I can write, right? What is the Fourier transform of 1? Fourier transform of 1. It is del of f, means impulse function. Okay, so I can write AC by pi into del of f. Similarly, next is what? See, again, I got a cos term only, right? Cos of 2 pi, here it is 2 FCT. So here it was only FCT, right? So here what I can write, the Fourier transform of this, del of f minus 2 fc plus del of f plus 2 fc by 2. Clear? So similarly for this one, this term. No? So here what is there? Cos of 2 by 4 fct is there. So for this, the Fourier transform, what I can write? Del of f minus 4 fc plus del of f plus 4 fc. Okay? Similar to that, for this term, del of what, f minus 2 fc plus del of f plus 2 fc by 2. Okay, so again, see, m of t multiplied by with the cos of 2 by 3 fct, right? So here what I can say, m of f, right, will be shifted to what frequency? 3 fc. I can write m of f minus 3 fc plus m of f plus 3 fc, right, with this magnitude. So with this, I will start the frequency domain analysis in the next class along with the spectrum. And let us have a clear discussion about how do we eliminate this unwanted terms and how do we take only the wanted one, that is the AM signal, and what filter to be used and what is the midband frequency of the bandpass filter and other things. Okay. Is it fine? Is it okay what I wrote today? You could understand clearly step by step?
Yeah, sir. This is yes. Better.
So I should go at this speed.
Yes, sir, because the thing is, when you explain it in PDF, it doesn't go in head. So sir, this is better.
Fine. I also understand. Only that writing only means at that moment only we need to write. Then only it is possible.
Yeah,
to answer. Fine. I will practice this. This is the first class writing live. Not an issue. Okay.
Yeah.
So thank you. So I will share the spectrum Monday. Fine. And all of you can write your revision in the chat box and you can log off. It's a waste of my phone.